Welcome to Around the Weird. Here's your host, the museum curator of the strange and unusual, Mr. Nothing.
Thank you, mysterious voice, and welcome back to Around the Weird, a BookTube channel where I talk about all the unusual and out of the ordinary literature that I have found in my travels. Today is, as I'm recording this, we're at the beginning of January. And I wanted to talk about the books that I read in December and what I plan to read in January. It's a wrap-up and TBR video. I took it easy in December just because I was on vacation from work and I wanted to just relax, and it felt really good to not have to read. The only thing I was really reading at the end of December anyways was Dune, which I'm still making my way through. It's a fun book, if a bit unusual. I'll have a video out for that either by the end of this week or the start of next week. Who knows? But I look forward to reading it and finishing it and discussing it, because there's already a lot of things going on like a quarter of the way through that are worth talking about, in my opinion. So as for January, I plan on finishing up some books and really getting a start on my the books that I want to read for 2022, and also checking out some random books from the library. So that's fun and exciting, and I can't wait to do it. So without further ado, let's talk about what I read in December, what I plan to read in January, and we'll move on from there. So in December, although I've read most of it in November, I didn't make a video until December, one of the first things that I talked about in December was Romeo and Juliet by William Shakespeare. It was a great play, one of his best, if not the best, Shakespeare play out there. I just really love the iconic quotes, of course, but also the dichotomy of emotions that go on, like how Shakespeare is talking about emotional extremes and how, you know, both sides aren't really that great. Like too great a love can, you know, lead to disaster. Too great of hate can lead to disaster. And also, you know, noting how a family feud ultimately led to the death of children. Everyone suffers in the end. Shakespeare is really good at it. And then I also, after that, I watched the Romeo plus Juliet movie that has Claire Danes and Leonardo DiCaprio, which I absolutely adore. It's one of my favorite movies. Baz Luhrmann has an interesting way of directing and an interesting filmmaking style, but I think it really shines with Romeo plus Juliet. Another book that I read was Tokyo Ueno Station by Miri Yu. I thought it was pretty good, although as time has gone on, I found it to be somewhat boring. I did think that Miri Yu made it, or like did a good job of exploring like homelessness and how, and like society's view of it, especially in Japan, and questioning like how can Japan afford like to not take care of the homelessness problem when they have plenty of money for the Olympics. So lots of interesting questions being asked, but outside of that, it was kind of a slow and plodding story. So a little bit torn on it. And I think as time goes on, my opinion of it might switch to just not caring as much about it. But I do think she has a lot of interesting ideas that we should consider in it. I also read The Canterbury Tales by Geoffrey Chaucer. I read this for a BookTube reading challenge from Lucas over at The Bits of Lit. I ended up beating him in that challenge because of course my thoughts and my analysis was top notch, and his was middle of the road, as it usually is. And so I am now the owner of the Golden Shawl. Please send it to me via whatever mail system can get from China to America. I will thank you very much. But as for the Canterbury Tales, I thought it was pretty good. I think it's interesting from a historical perspective, as I said in the video I made, how we can gain a lot from understanding what was going on in Europe, England, those areas at the time. But for the casual reader, I don't think you can really gain too much from reading the whole thing. Maybe one story out of the entire collection is worth reading on its own, but to read the whole thing, I wouldn't recommend it. Given it's kind of hard to parse at times, and nobody, like, it's written in a style that some people might find hard to read nowadays, and there's anti-Semitism, which I can't recommend. So, maybe it's important in an academic context, but not outside of that. At least I don't think so. I mean, there's also a lot you can say about the Western literary canon, but I have a bunch of issues with saying anything is canon or not. So, you know, it just remains to be seen how important it is in terms of its literary impact. But I will say a lot of the stories are fascinating, and the interactions between the characters within the stories themselves are fascinating. So a lot to discuss there. I also read some comics that I did not talk about on this channel just because there wasn't a lot worth talking about. I read Batman Graveyard Shift, which is actually newer, having been published like less than 10 years ago. And it's fascinating in terms of some of the new ideas that were being introduced about Batman, such as Year Zero and the DC reboot that took place, and how you end up with different versions of Joker and new characters as well. But I didn't end up liking the collection as a whole, just because I felt that the big problem was that it was too focused around major storylines like Batman Incorporated and the death of Damian Wayne, which again is another thing I have a problem with. Like, if you're gonna kill another one of Batman's allies, like, at a certain point, people have to start to say, Batman, why are you recruiting young people? You shouldn't be doing that. But ultimately, I think that it's a fun collection. It just, there wasn't a lot to talk about otherwise. So I also read Mr. Punch by Neil Gaiman, the tragical comedy or comical tragedy of Mr. Punch, which was about a Punch and Judy man and his grandson, and the experience that he goes through and the terror that he feels about Mr. Punch, which I thought it was great and kind of terrifying art. And it's also sort of presented from a young person's perspective. Like what would a child be thinking about all of this? But I felt like it could have been longer, and Gaiman introduces a lot of interesting ideas, but doesn't really follow up on them because of the short nature of this graphic novel story. So, like, it has a lot of potential that I feel doesn't really land. So it's more middle of the road than anything else. I can't really recommend it, but if you're looking for something different from Neil Gaiman, definitely check it out. I also only read two short stories for this month. The first was The Polar Express, which I thought was a lot of fun. And the second was A Kidnapped Santa Claus by L. Frank Baum, which I thought was interesting in that it added to the lore of Christmas, although my big problem with it is that there wasn't a lot of substance to it otherwise. So it adds to the Santa lore, the Santa mythology that we built up in society, but it doesn't really hit anything. It doesn't really stand out beyond that. I wouldn't say it's worth remembering or anything like that. And then I also read poems this month, including A Visit from St. Nicholas, which has disputed authorship. And that's a poem that's worth reading during the Christmas time. So maybe next Christmas or next holiday season, you can go out and seek that out. So what do I plan on reading in January? I have a lot of books planned. In terms of reading the books in particular, I do want to finish Dune. Just some early thoughts. I'm about a quarter of the way through. And I do think, as I may have mentioned before, that Frank Herbert, is that his name? That's probably his name. He's good at setting up this world and building it up. But so far, it's been all set up. And maybe that's just because I'm a quarter of the way through. But, there's only so much setup you can do before you have to, play around with this world that you've built. And I don't feel that Frank Herbert is doing that quite yet. Although, again, I'm only a quarter of the way through, so that it remains to be seen what else he does. I also want to read The Shadow King by Maza Mengistu, I think is her name, or their name. I don't know too much about this. This was recommended to me by my friend Bevan, who does not have a YouTube channel yet. But she recommended it, and it's going to be another book that I look up and see what I think about. But she's been recommending some pretty quality books to me over the past year, I would say. So, looking forward to seeing what I might find from The Shadow King. I also want to read a number of comic books that I've been checking out from my local library. Again, as I pointed out in my 2022 TBR video, I do want to check out more comic books than simply Batman. So I'm going to try to see, what my library has to offer, and also maybe go into look online for more older comic books. I also want to read Beautiful Country by Qian Wang. That is a memoir by an Asian American author, which I always need to read more Asian literature, whether it be people from Asia or Asian Americans. I look forward to reading that. So that's also part of the book club that I'm in with my friend Bevan. So another recommended book. But yeah, I'm really excited because it is an Asian American author, and I just love to read about those kinds of different experiences. And the last book that I have on my list is Cannery Row by John Steinbeck. Cannery Row was on my TBR for 2022, and I hope to get to it by the end of this month. If I don't get to it by the end of this month, I will definitely read it for February. Although this might end up being like Beowulf, where I say I'm going to read it throughout the entire year, and I just never get to it, but hopefully not. I do love Steinbeck, so I can't wait to read another one of his works. In terms of short stories for 2020, or for January at least of this year, I do want to read one by Laura Vampinar, something like that. I'm currently in the process of making a video for the short story collection that I read by her, so be on the lookout for that. And I also want to look up or read some more of, finally check out Kate Chopin, who is constantly referred to me whenever I look up short story collections. So finally going to get to that and several others that I think should be good or at least interesting. And then I want to read a number of poems too. I do want to check out a book that was published recently by Misha Collins. Misha Collins is the actor who plays Castiel in Supernatural, a show that I have a love-hate relationship with. But Misha Collins recently wrote a book of poetry, and I've heard someone say, at least one person say, that it's pretty good. So I do want to check out that. I might do that later on this month, just to give myself some time to fully read through his collection of poetry. So be on the lookout for that too. That was the TBR. Along with the wrap-up. If you have any suggestions for me on what to read in January or possibly February, definitely tell them to me below in the comments. I would love to hear from you. Let's have a discussion about books. Otherwise, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe so that more people can find out about, the books that I might be recommending or about this channel in general. And until then, I wish you the best of luck in your weird and January-ish travels. Farewell.